A very good evening to you all. Welcome to the presentation contest of Level 4 students of Path to Success International Matara. Path to Success International Matara is a distinctive educational institute which aims to upskill the soft skills, especially oral skills of English language of school-going children. Today, we are about to witness another significant event of Path to Success International Matara, the presentation contest of Level 4 students 2022. I am honored and I take this opportunity to introduce the chief judge of today's event. She's a final year undergraduate of software engineering at SLIT and a software engineering intern. She's also a proud past student of St. Mary's Convent Matara. I am pleased to say that she is a very talented student of mine during my period at St. Mary's Convent Matara as a teacher. She was a very good actress in Shakespearean dramas I trained at school. My dear students, parents, and guests, let's welcome Ms. Kanchana Christambu on screen. Ms. Kanchana, we are honored to have you as the chief judge of this event.
She is all mine, Tisha. Thank you for inviting me for this event.
Right. Okay, so now moving on to the next step of the agenda. I wish to give a brief description about the contest rules. All the contestants are expected to prepare and orally present a PowerPoint presentation on any topic selected under the broad theme of history. The time allocated for a contestant is 5 to 10 minutes. I repeat, the time allocated for a contestant is 5 to 10 minutes. If a contestant encounters an issue of the internet connection, that contestant will be given another attempt after all the other contestants presented. We expect all the contestants to maintain strict online meeting etiquettes throughout the meeting. The timer will report the time consumed by each contestant soon after each presentation. Now everything is ready to start today's contest. Without much ado, let's start the contest. Contestant number one, Ramiru Vektage, can you please turn on your camera? And right, okay, I'll put you on spotlight and you can share the screen and get ready to present.
Animation is about creating the illusion of our life, but you can't create it if you don't have one. This quote is by Brad Bird, an American film director. By this quote, we can understand that animation is not just a nonsense. It's a portrait of our own life. My dear friends, I know that you all love animation. Animation has a long history. Aren't you interested? Respected judges, guests, parents, and my dear friends. I'm Ramiru Vektage, and I'm a grade 8 student of Royal College Colombo 7. And I'm a level 4 student of Path to Success English Academy Matara. Without much further ado, let's talk about the history of animation. First, I will talk about my presentation's outline. First, I will talk about early stages of animation. Then, I will talk about animation after the invention of camera. Then I'll talk about the colored animation. Then lastly, I will talk about CGI. First, what exactly is animation? Animation is a method which figures are manipulated to appear as moving objects. As an example, cartoons such as Shrek, Cinderella, Peter Pan, and anime such as Naruto, One Piece, and even movies like Marvel, DC, and Harry Potter uses animation. Animation offers a medium of storytelling and visual entertainment, which can bring pleasure and information to people of all ages everywhere in the world. This was Walt Disney's idea about animation. Now let's talk about the early stages of animation. Phonetic stethoscope. Arguably, it's the first animation device. Belgian Joseph and Plato found stethoscope in 1832. It's a device which, looking through slits at the reflection in the mirror, that shows you a little animation. Zoetrope. When multiple images blend into a single moving image in the human mind, that shows you an illusion. In 1834, William George Ohnet invented the zoetrope. Praxinoscope. In 1877, Charles Emil Reynaud invented the praxinoscope. It was an animation device, which was the successor to the zoetrope. Can you see these little slides? When you roll it, you can see a little animation through these little mirrors. Now let's talk about animation's next step with the invention of the camera. In the 90s, the films were officially releasing, and the animation to take another step toward the future. Humorous faces or funny faces were released in 1906. It was an animated cartoon. It was a moving drawn cartoon. They had to draw a lot to make an animation like this. Gertie the Dinosaur. Gertie the Dinosaur is an animated short film in 1914 by American cartoonist and animator Vincent Mackey. What's important about this little film is that Gertie was the first animated character. To be a character, she had a personality and a gender. Steamboat Willie. It was Disney's first production. It was a short film released in 1928. It was the first animation to produce music as sound. And also, it was the first cartoon to show violence. And it showcased Mickey and Minnie for the first time. Wall Street Crash in 1929. In 1929, Wall Street crashed. Billions of dollars were lost. And this led to America's 10 years of depression. People lost their jobs, their homes, but they had money. They were able to feed themselves and their families, but they were very bored. There was nothing to do. There was nowhere to go but the theater. Lots of people started to go to the theater to watch animation, like Skeleton Dance by Walt Disney. And through this time, animation evolved a lot. And this led to Snow White, one of the best movies at the time, and it changed animation forever. Snow White was released in 1938. It was the first fully animated colored movie by Disney. Snow White had human emotions because animators had dressed over a real person. As an example, they took a real woman dancing and they dressed over her so they can gain real motions to Snow White. It raised over $3.8 million and it's very famous to this very own day. Pixar. Pixar was founded in 1986. It is an animating company which is owned by Walt Disney Company in this present day. Their founders were Steve Jobs, John Lasseter, Edwin Catmull, Elvira Smith, and Alexander Skull. And they started CGI for the first time. CGI means computer-generated imagery. These animations are created through the computer. These animations were on the next level. This is Woody, Pixar's first movie protagonist. Animations in this modern day, studios like Disney, Warner Brothers, Pixar, Studio Ghibli, Toy Animations, 20th Century Fox, etc. uses animations for movies themselves. However, the movies are depending on animation in this modern day. Did you know that shooting and fighting movies use CGI too? Moreover, I would like to remind you that you have to live a life to create a life. So live a life. Don't stare at the screen all day. In conclusion, I would like to remind you that animations that you are watching today is a long way of process. So you must admire it. Animators have to live a life to create a life. Looking through this history of animations, it caught my interest. As well, I learned a lot. How about you? Thank you. Over to you, teacher.
Ramiro, it was a wonderful presentation about the history of animations. We learned a lot from your presentation. Thank you very much for taking part in today's contest. Ramiro, timer, Minaga, can you report his time?
Contestant number one, Ramiro Vattage. His time was 7 minutes and 20 seconds.
Thank you, Minaga. Then let's move to contestant number two, Haritha Hansanan. Can you please turn on your camera? Okay. Right, so Minaga is our first timer. So I would like to appoint another timer for today's contest. If Ramiro get disconnected or something happens like that. Nathan? Yes. Nathan, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Nathan, are you there? Can you hear me, Nathan?
Hello?
All right. Can you also do the part of a timer today?
Okay.
Right, you will be the second person, right? Okay?
Okay.
Right, very good. Okay, then our friend Haritha is there. Okay, Haritha, we can see the screen.
Hello everyone, Honorable Judge, dear teacher, and my dear friends. I am Gambhir Haritha Hansan. I am a grade 7 student of Bahulu College, Madhura. I am a level 4 student of Path to Success International, Madhura. Today I am going to share some fascinating information of two historical places that even today engineers get amazed by. Those two places are quite popular in today's generation. So today I'm going to share some uncommon facts about Sigiriya and Stonehenge. My first topic is Stonehenge. Specialty of the Stonehenge is that we haven't still discovered the purpose of this creation. First, I'm going to discuss it about this place. Then the location. Then I'm going to discuss it about what was found in Stonehenge. What is this place? Stonehenge is certainly Britain's greatest national symbol, symbolizing mystery, strength, and stamina. Its original purpose is unclear to us, but some have suspected that it was a temple to worship the ancient gods of Earth. Some people say it had been a burial site, or maybe it had been a place for healing. The purpose is still unclear to us. Where is this place located? Stonehenge is a prehistorical monument on Salisbury Plain in Wiltshire, England, 3 kilometers west of Assembly. It consists of an outer ring of vertical cells and standing stones, each around 30 feet high, 7 feet wide, and weighing around 25 tons, topped by connecting horizontal linked stones. Stone has been legally protected scheduled ancient monument since 1882. What was found in Stonehenge? Dr. William Harvey and Gilbert North were the first people to discover in early 17th century. After that, Ignor Jones and Duke of Buckingham both dug there. The excavation teams discovered bone frame, pottery, deer antlers, and burial pits, among other discoveries. The graves contains both a child's earbud and a pot, as well as women who died in the 20s or 30s and was buried with something distinctive that may have been a shared object. Researchers discovered that Stonehenge was made of nearly indestructible materials during the test on the site. The quartz content of core sample is only slightly higher than that other cores that have been found. My next topic is a place that gets the most tourist attraction in Sri Lanka. Can you guess what is this place? It is Sivirya. First, I'm going to explain about this place, then the location, and then I'm going to explain about wonderful places in Sivirya. What is this place? King Kashva built his palace on top of the rock and decorated its sides with colorful face houses. On a small plateau about halfway up the side of the rock, he built a gateway form of an enormous lion. According to the ancient Sri Lankan chronicle, this area was a large forest. Then after storms and landslides, it became a hill and was selected by King Kashva for his new capital. And also, Lion Rock is another name for Sivirya. Not only that, my friends, Sivirya had been in the list of 7 wonders. Location of this place. Sivirya is an ancient rock fortress located in Northern Mathalai district near the town of Dabulwe in Central Province, Sri Lanka. It is a site historical and archaeological significance that is dominated by massive columns of rock at approximately 180 meters high. Wonderful places in Sivirya. Sivirya consists of an ancient citadel built by King Kashva during 5th century. The Sivirya site contains the ruins of an upper palace located on the flat top of the rock, a mid-level terrace that includes Lion Gate and the mirror wall with its face houses. The lower palace leans to the slope below the rocks. The moats, walls, and guards of the palace extended for a few hundred meters from the base of the rock. The site was both a palace and a fortress. The upper palace on top of the rock includes cylindrons cut into rock. And also, my dear friends, Sivirya face houses have a close resemblance to the painting seen in India. As you can see, this is a picture of face houses in Ajanta Caves in India, and this is a picture of face houses in Sivirya in Sri Lanka. Water guns. The water guns are built symmetrically on east and west axis. They are connected with the outer moats on the west and large artificial lake to the south of the Sivirya rock. All the pools are interlinked using an underground conduit network fed by the lake. and connected to the moats. A miniature water garden is located to the west of the first garden, consisting of several small pools and watercourses. This recently discovered smaller gardens appear to have been built after King Kashan period, possibly between 10th and 13th century. So, some creation as Stonehenge and Sigri is still a mystery. So, we can think as there was a deal of technology. Then, what is the uses of learning from history? We should learn from history and make our future success. I think you learned some new facts about Sigri and Stonehenge. It's our duty to protect these amazing places. It is a thing that we must do. We must protect this heritage. Thank you for being with me. Over to you, teacher.
Right, Harita. It was a wonderful presentation about our heritage, Sigri, and also you explained a lot of facts about this Stone Age also. Right, thank you very much for taking part in today's contest. Timer, Minaga, can you please report his time?
Contestant number 2, Harita Hansaran. His time was 7 minutes and 2 seconds.
Thank you, Minaga. Then let's move to contestant number 3, Chama Fernando. Can you please turn on your camera, Chama? Okay. Chama, your camera is not on. All right. Now it's on. Right. Okay, you can share the screen and start to present.
Ships are the largest ocean liner on high seas, as well as the largest mode of transport from cargo to boat, sail, etc. Today, ship has become a vessel that continues to be used commercially. Not only that, it is also at the forefront of passenger transport. No other means of transportation can carry such large load at once. In addition, it does a great service in transporting goods around the world. Respected judge, teacher, guests, and my dear friends. I'm Chama Sanjali Fernando. I'm in grade 7. I'm a student of Sujata Vidyalaya Mathur. I'm a level 4 student of Path Success International Mathur. Today, I will talk about history of ships that play such a big role in transportation. My presentation outlines. First, I will introduce you what is a ship. Then I will talk about origin and evolution of ship use. Then I will share some important facts about ships in early days. Then I will talk about sailing era and steamship era. Then I will talk about the types of ships used at present. And then at last, conclusion of my presentation. Introduction of ships. What is a ship? There are 4 main modes of transportation in this world. There are transportation by land, air, sea, and other waterways. Of these, land transport is the most popular, but air and sea transport are also widely used today. Waterways have become a low-cost and efficient method of transporting goods around the world. Ships played an important role in human migration and commerce. In the past, as well as the colonial expansion, the slave trade was carried out with the help of ships. Also, the service rendered by the ships for scientific, cultural, and humanitarian purposes is not insignificant. origin and evolution of ship use. So how these ships originated? We have heard that boats and ferries have been used since ancient times. The foundations of the use of these boats and ferries date back to the construction of large-scale ships. Sail-like vessels were also designed. In the past, these sailing ships were used extensively for exploration as well as for trade. However, it is said that the ancient Egyptians knew how to make ships from wooden planks. The wreckage of a shipwreck has been found in the Turkish Sea. It is considered to be the oldest ship ever found, and it's unique that it belongs to Egypt. However, it is reported that Mohenjo-Daro Harappa is also contributed to the ship. Following the Renaissance, the shipbuilding industry flourished. Ships of various shapes and sizes are widely used for trade. With the expansion of shipping companies around the world, the shipping industry gradually came to be known as a lucrative business, with ports being developed. In the early 8th century, the French Navy built a fleet of small vessels of each type. They called it a ship of line. They were the ships used in shipping industry. They were also improved in size and facilities. This technology later spread throughout Europe, and they further developed these vessels. Large ships of this length and breadth were built by Europe using oak. By 2007, there were a large number of naval vessels joining the shipping industry worldwide. Oil, goods, and other things were also transported through these vessels in ancient times. Ships in the early days. So, how does the ships in the early days look like? Now you can see some pictures of the ships that used in the early days. Large vessels used for transporting water are known as ships. Ships are used in the world's oceans and seas, as well as on other deep sea routes or for specialized operations such as cargo transportation, research, and fishing. Do you know, my dear friends, historically a ship was a wind-powered vessel, and these types of vessels contain at least 3 square domes. These are considered to be port capacity and tradition. Maritime transport has played an important role in land links between the East and Europe came to a standstill, a major land route from Constantinople. Due to this situation, they came to the East in search of new sea routes by using ships. At present, however, ships have joined the fleet, which is at an advanced level of security. At the same time, these ships playing a vital role in the economic development of the country. Early ships used either hulls or sails to navigate. Around 4000 BC, the ancient Egyptians built sailing ships out of wood. Around 1200 BC, the Phoenicians and Greeks began to build large ships. They were about 30 meters long and could carry between 80 and 100 tons of cargo. The Romans were able to build even larger ships. Roman ships could carry up to 1,000 people and carry about 1,000 tons of cargo. Production of long ships began around the 8th century with the growth of the Vikings. These were mainly used for transportation to other countries as well as for transporting goods. These long ships had flat bottoms, therefore they were able to navigate even in shallow rivers. Now I'm going to talk about sailing era. Sailing era means the time period that people used sailing ships. Although sailing has been used for thousands of years, it made significant contributions to welfare and trade between the 1500s and 1800s. In the 15th century, under the command of a Chinese admiral named Chiang Hai, a navy sailed seven seas across the Asia and from there to East Africa with ships loaded with treasure. According to reports, the ship was about 130 meters long and 50 meters wide. Accordingly, these Chinese ships were about twice the size of the largest European ships of the 16th century. The Dutch were the most successful and largest naval force of the 17th century. The Dutch often used a special type of merchant ship for trade and transportation called the fleet. Then I will share some important facts about the steamship era with you. Steamship era means the time period that human used steamships. The 19th century saw the introduction of steamship for cruises. The Titanic, the Olympic, and the Britannic were once the largest steamship in the world. During its maiden voyage, Titanic crashed into an iceberg and sank in the Atlantic Ocean. The Titanic disaster is considered to be one of the most serious shipwrecks ever, with an all-rounder on the Olympic Titan. In fact, it joined the cruises even before the Titanic. It was removed from the sea in the 1930s, having played a successful role as a passenger ship and a First World War warship. The largest of the three ships was the Britannic. It is considered to be even larger and more luxurious than the Titanic. First World War broke out before the first voyage, and its beautiful furniture and windows were removed and turned into a naval hospital. The ship sank after being bombed while serving as a hospital ship. But why it sank is still a mystery. As the Titanic kissed the bottom of the North Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Nova Scotia, the Britannic sank off the coast of the island. Now you can see pictures of the ships called Titanic, Britannic, and Olympic. You can see that they have many similar features. Then I will share some important facts about the types of ships used at present. Bulk carrier. These types of ships are very large, and these types of ships are used to transport very heavy goods. Next one is catamaran. The specialty of this kind of ships is they have two decks. Next one is cruise ships. These types of ships are used to transport people from one country to another during their vacation, and these are very comfortable. Next type of ship is ferry. Ferries are used to transport vehicles. Next one is super tanker. It's known as super tanker. The last one is aircraft ships, as well as these types of ships are used to transport aeroplanes. Then I will conclude my presentation. However, man has now been able to make ships more, that future is not far off, no doubt about it. But we should consider about the repercussions of it too. So I think you learn a lot about history of ships from my presentation. Thank you for being with me. Over to you, teacher.
Yes, indeed. We learned a lot, many facts about the history of ships from your wonderful presentation, Charma, thank you very much for taking part in today's contest. Timer, can you please report her time?
Contestant number 3, Charma Fernando. Her time was 11 minutes and 20 seconds.
Right. Okay. 11 minutes and 20 seconds. Right. Now, according to the rules, the time allocated for one contestant to present is 5 minutes to 10 seconds. It's all right. You will not be penalized, Charma. Don't worry about it, right? But the thing is, you should have minimum time of 5 minutes for your presentation. That is according to the rules of the this contest, right? Okay. Then we'll move to the next contestant. Contestant number 4, Umeda Samarasinghe. Okay, Putta. Wait, Umeda, where are you now? Umeda, I can't see you. I mean, is your camera on? Okay, right. So can you please adjust your camera a bit, my darling? You appear as that Alice in Wonderland, right? Alice had eaten that cake and you appear as the giant Alice. Now it's all right. Okay, now that's good. All right, my darling. Right, okay. So now you can start presenting.
Dear Honorable Judge, my name is Umeda Yashasvi Samarasinghe.
I'm sorry to interrupt, my darling. Can you please start the presentation? I mean, we can't see the full view.
Okay, sure.
Right. Timer, you can start timing when she starts, right? Minagu?
Okay, Reza.
All right, Umeda. Contestant number 4, Umeda Samarasinghe.
Dear Honorable Judge, my name is Umeda Yashasvi Samarasinghe. I'm a grade 7 student in Sujata Vidyalaya. Do you know about paramechanics? So, without wasting time, let's move to presentation. Paramechanics. My presentation includes early proposals in Panama, French construction attempts, United States acquisition, United States construction of the Panama Canal, and later developments. Early proposals in Panama. The earliest record regarding a canal across the of Panama was in 1534, when Charles V, Holy Roman Emperor and King of Spain, ordered a survey for a route to the Americas in order to ease the voyage for ships traveling between Spain and Peru. In 1668, the English physician and philosopher Sir Thomas Brown speculated in his encyclopedic work, Loxia endemica, that some have been eaten through by the sea and others cut by the spear. And if the policy would permit that of Panama and America were most worthy attempt, it being but few miles over and would open a shorter cut into the East Indies and China. French construction attempts. Ferdinand de Lesseps, the French originator of the Suez Canal and the Panama Canal, the first attempt to construct a canal through what was the Colombia East province of Panama began on January 1, 1881. The project was inspired by the diplomat Ferdinand de Lesseps, who was able to raise considerable funds in France as a result of few profits generated by his successful construction of the Suez Canal. Although the Panama Canal needed to be only 40% as known as the Suez Canal. It was much more of an engineering challenge due to the combination of tropical rainforest, debilitating climate, the need for canal locks, and the lack of an ancient route into Pharaoh. Lesseps wanted sea level canal, but he visited the site only a few times. During the dry season, which lasts only 4 months of the year, his men were totally unprepared for the rainy season, during which the Cargos River, where the canal started, became raging torrent rising up to 10 meters. The dense jungle was a limit when snakes, insects, and spiders, but the worst challenges were yellow fever, malaria, and other tropical diseases, which killed thousands of Moroccans by 1884. The death rate was over 200 per month. Public health measure was effective because the role of the mosquitoes as a disease vector was the unknown. Conditions were downplayed in France to avoid. United States admission. The U.S.'s intention to influence the area led to the separation of Panama from Colombia in 1903. This is a picture of Culebra Cut in 1896, and the second picture is picture of Culebra Cut in 1902. At this time, the President and the Senate of the United States were instructed in establishing a canal across the isthmus with some favoring across Narragansett and other advocating the purchase of the French interest in Panama. On January 22, 1903, the Hay Herring Treaty was signed by United States Secretary of State John M. Hay and Colombian Judge Dr. Thomas Herring. United States construction of the Panama Canal. This is a picture of Chief Engineer John Frank Stevens, and this is a picture of Sanitation Officer William C. Joyce. The U.S. formally took control of the canal property on May 4, 1904, inheriting from the French depleted workforce and a vast jumble of buildings, infrastructure, and equipment, much of it in poor condition. A U.S. government commission, the Ismail Canal Commission, was established to over which United States exercised sovereignty. The commission reported directly to Secretary of War William Howard Taft and was directed to avoid the infringements and corruption that had plagued the French 15 years earlier. Later developments. The USS Missouri and lower class battleship passes through the canal in 1945. The 182 beams of the Lavis and President's Departure class were the largest ever to transit the canal. By the 1930s, water supply became an issue for the canal, prompting construction of the maiden dam across Tajus River above Gatineau Lake. Completed in 1935, the dam created Maiden Lake, which provides additional water storage for the canal. In 1939, construction began on a future major improvement, a new improvement. A new set of locks large enough to carry the larger warships and that the United States was building at the time and planned to continue building the world cross for several years, and significant excavation was carried out on the new approach channels, but the project was cancelled after World War. After World War, it was started from beginning. So today we talk about early proposals in Panama, French construction attempts, United States acquisition, United States construction of the Panama Canal, and later development. Thank you.
All right, Umeda, it was a wonderful presentation about Panama Canal. We learned many facts from your presentation. Thank you for sharing your knowledge with us. And timer, can you please report her time?
Contestant number 4, Umeda Samarasinghe. Her time was 7 minutes and 55 seconds.
Thank you, Minaga. Then let's move to contestant number 5, Sehas. Can you please turn on the camera, Sehas? I put you on spotlight. Okay, you can share the screen and start to present. Sehas, can you also adjust the camera so that we can see, get a good view of your face? We can't see you now, Sehas? Okay, that's better. That's better, Putta. Okay.
Good evening, respected judge, guest, and my dear friends. I am Sehas Metsindhu. I am a student of St. Thomas Boys College, Mathur, and I am in grade 8. I am a level 4 student of Path to Success International, Mathur. Today, I am going to talk about history of computer. Let's see. What are the content? What is a computer? Who invented? Shengo Bon, the first calculating device. Chinese Wanpan, the Antikythera mechanism. Charles Babbage, difference engine. Analog computers. Sir William Thomson's third type predicting machine. Digital computers. Replica of Conrad Suse's Z3. The first fully automatic digital electromechanical computer. Colossus, the first digital electronic programmable computing device. ENISC, was the first electronic Turing complete device. Modern computer. How the computer will evolve in the future? Let's see, what is a computer? A computer is a digital electronic machine that can be programmed to carry out sequences of arithmetic or logical operations, computation automatically. Modern computer can perform generic sets of operations known as programs. These programs enable computers to perform a wide range of tasks. Who invented? The first computer was invented by Mr. Charles Babbage. That was a primary level computer and it was huge like a house. Let's see basic foundation of computer evolution was. Shengo Bon, the earliest computing device, is a tall stick older than thousands of years. And it founded from Africa. Next, the Chinese Xuanpan. Xuanpan was about 20 centimeters tall and it came in various widths depending on other application, and it usually had more than 7 rods. There were 2 beads on each rod in the bottom deck. The beads were usually rounded and made of a hardwood. The beads were counted by moving them up or down towards the beam. Xuanpan could be used for functions other than counting. The Antikythera mechanism. The artifact was among wreckage retrieved from a shipwreck off the coast of the Greek island Antikythera in 1901. On 17 May 92, it was identified as a counting gear by archaeologist Valerius Tis. This instrument was believed to have been designed to constructed by Greek scientists and had been variously dated to about 87 BC or between 150 BC and 100 BC or 205 BC. Antikythera mechanism are now kept at the National Archaeological Museum, Athens town in Greece. Charles Babbage Difference Engine. Charles Babbage, an English mechanical engineer and polymath, originated the concept of programmable computer, considered the father of the computer. He conceptualized and invented the first mechanical computer in 19th century. Difference engine can calculate any number of nearby values. The machine was about a century ahead of its time. All the parts of his machine had to be made by hand. This was the major problem for a device with thousands of parts. Eventually, the project was dissolved with decision of British government to cast funding. Nevertheless, his son Henry Babbage completed the simplified version of the analytical engine's computing unit in 1888. He gave a successful demonstration of its using computing tables in 1906. Analog computers. What is an analog computer? Analog computer means we choose a direct mechanical or electrical model of the problem as a basis for computation. However, these are not programmable and generally lack the versatility and accuracy of modern digital computers. The first analog modern computer was a type predictive machine invented by Sir William Thomson in 1872. Sir William Thomson's third type predictive machine. Type predictive machine was a special purpose mechanical analog computer of late 19th and early 20th century. The first type predictive machine designed and built in 1872 and 1873 and followed by two larger machines on similar principle in 1876 and 1879 was conceived by Sir William Thomson. Digital computers. Early digital computers were electromechanical electric switches, draw mechanical relays to perform the calculation. These devices had low operating speed and were eventually superseded by much faster all electric computers, originally using vacuum tubes. Replica of Conrad Suse's Z3, the first fully automatic digital electromechanical computer. The Z3, created by German engineer Conrad Suse in 1939, Z2 was one of the earliest examples of an electromechanical relay computer. In 1941, Suse followed his earlier machine up with Z3, the world's first working electromechanical programmable fully automatic digital computer. The Z3 was built in 2000 relays, implementing 22-bit word length that operated at a clock frequency about 5 to 10 hertz. Colossus, the first electromechanical digital programmable computing device, used to break German shippers during World War II. Colossus, the first world's electronic digital programmable computer. It used a large number of valves. Colossus contained 2,400 valves. ENIAC, Electronic Numerical The ENIC was the first electronic Turing complete device and it was built in US. Although the ENIC was similar to the Colossus, but ENIC was much faster, more flexible, and it was Turing complete. The machine was huge, weighing 30 tons, using 200 kilowatts of electric power, and obtained over 18,000 vacuum tubes and 1,500 relays. Modern computers. Modern computer is an electric device that has the ability to store, retrieve, and process data. Modern computers can perform tasks such as word processing, web browsing, and database management. A modern computer is made of hardware and software components. Hardware refers to the part of the computer that has a physical component, such as keyboard and mouse. Software is the software is any sets of instruction Modern computers come in the form of desktop computers and laptop computers. Desktop computers are usually used at work, home, school, or library, and easy to upgrade. Laptop computers. Other types of computers include tablets, mobile phones, gaming consoles, and TVs. How the computer will evolve in the future? We are already seeing AI, artificial intelligence, in action today in computers. It is a constantly evolving technology that will make computers more intelligent. AI will impact computers in a big way in the future. Industries, hospitals, services, manufacturing, education, farming, all will change so much when computers are powered by artificial intelligence. Computer will give automation and a new meaning with artificial intelligence. Robots will be serving your dishes, cleaning your car, or making your home more sure. Thank you for being with me.
All right, Sehas, it was a wonderful presentation about the history of computers. It was an informative presentation about the history of computers, I should say. Right, thank you very much for taking part in today's contest. Then our timer, can you please report his time?
Contestant number 5, Sehas Metsindu. His time was 10 minutes and 45 seconds.
Then let's move to contestant number 6, Netuli Dihansa. Netuli, can you please turn on your camera? Right. You can share the screen and start to present.
It's marvelous, a giant mass of rocks and water flying through space. It's a heaven. There is food to eat, water to drink, air to breathe, and perfect breeding ground for life. Have you ever heard such a place in this universe? The Earth. Honorable judges, my dear teacher, and my dear friends, I'm Netuli Dihansa. I'm in grade 7 and I'm student of Telichery Central College and I'm level 4 student of Patrusaksar incidental in Mataram. Now, let's move to the incredible history of the Earth. Formation of the Earth, birth of the moon, formation of the water, creation of first continent, first life, production of oxygen and other minerals, making continents. Formation of the Earth. According to the scientists, about 5 billion years ago, there was no signs of birth of the Earth. Only the sun, a newly born star, surrounded by a ring of gas and dust. But through the time, with the gravity, this dust got together into tiny rocks. Over millions of years, these rocks got together and made as complex as planet. The Earth was born. About 4.5 billion years ago, Earth looked like a hell. Its temperature was over 2000 degrees of Fahrenheit. There's no air, only carbon dioxide and nitrogen and water vapor. It was too hot, too toxic, just like a boiling ball of liquid rock. If we got any closer, we would be incinerated in seconds. Birth of the moon. After several million years, the Earth colloided with a young planet called Theia and distorted the Earth's surface. The moon was gradually formed. Earlier, it was much closer than the Earth today. It was 14,000 miles away from the Earth. As well as the Earth was spinning so fast, entire day last 6 hours. Formation of the water. About 3.9 million years ago, there was a huge hail of meteors attacked the Earth. Inside the meteors, there were droplets of water and vital ingredients for life. Over 20 million of years, this water grew on the Earth. So Earth's surface cooled enough and made a crust. In present, every sip of water you swallow, every puddle of water you touch, every drop of water in every ocean is billions of years old. Creation of first continent. After 700 million years, life-giving water covered the Earth's surface. Molten rocks burst through the ocean. Over time, the lava which came out from the rock cooled and formed the volcanic island. This island joined together and made first continent. First life. About 3.8 billion years ago, violent hail of meteor attacked the Earth several times. They brought carbon, minerals, prime to proteins made of amino acid to the Earth. They were combined and transported together to the bottom of the ocean. After thousands of years, these minerals helped to create life and single cell of bacteria was born. Production of oxygen and other minerals. About 3.5 billion years ago, there were complex life in the shallow ocean. They were colony of bacteria. They produced food by using photosynthesis process. And large amount of oxygen released to the ocean many years. As the result, iron-rich rock deposit under the water. In present, people use this iron for making bridges, aircraft, ships, etc. Not only that, this oxygen transforms the atmosphere to the space, which helped to create most important element for life. Over the next 2 billion years, Earth spins slowly and the day lasts for 16 hours. Making continents. About 1.5 billion years ago, Earth looked like a blue ball. Earth's crust broken into vast plates even deeper and started to move. Then supercontinent made. Ice Age. About 650 million years ago, planet was a snowball. The Earth faced longest and coldest ice age. During this period, glaciers melted and huge amount of oxygen released and ozone gas was made. This ozone gas formed blanket around the planet and absorbed the radiation. Without this layer, life and land wouldn't exist. Evolution of human beings. About 541 million years ago, huge number of living organisms appeared. Some creatures developed exoskeleton. 450 million years ago, plants and arthropods began to conquer the land. 419 million years ago, first insect appeared. Some swarms appeared. Giant insects flew everywhere. Some plants reached to 30 meters high. 252 million years ago, there was a huge disaster. Almost every creature was destroyed and only 1% of them exist. 175 million years ago, the Atlantic and other oceans appeared. First pine trees and beans also appeared. Through the time, mammals spread everywhere. About 8.5 billion years ago, modern apes' ancestors began to separate from our ancestors. Later, they climbed down from the trees and stand up straight and start looking for food. After that, Homo erectus began to colonize to Eurasia and they learned how to use fire. About 300,000 years ago, Homo sapiens appeared. They were discerning humans. They began to colonize the entire Earth so actively until today. Now, you can understand how and why everything around us is here. So, let's protect our world for the future. Thank you. Over to you, teacher.
Thank you, Nethuli, for enlightening all of us regarding this evolution of the Earth. It was a wonderful presentation, Nethuli. And Taima, can you please report her time?
Contestant number 6, Nethuli Dahansa. Her time was 7 minutes and 20 seconds.
Thank you, Minagal. Then let's move to contestant number 7. Dinuja Ranasingha, can you please turn on your camera, Putta? Right. Okay. Putta, can you please adjust the camera to see your face nicely? All right. That's great. Okay. Then you can share the screen and
good evening, respected judge and teachers. I am Dinuja Mechal Ranasinghe. I am Rowland College of Madurai. I am developer student of Path to Success International Madurai. I am going to present history of dinosaurs.
Dinuja, you are on mute.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Dinuja. You are muted, my darling. I'm sorry. Right. Don't worry about it, right? Can you please unmute your mic? Dinuja, I'm sorry to interrupt. Dinuja?
Sorry.
Okay. Right. All right. Now, you can start from the beginning. Right. Timer, stop timing. And, okay. Right, Dinuja, don't worry, you can start from the beginning, right? Okay.
Good evening, dear judges and teachers and friends. I'm Dinuja Vachar Ranasinghe. I am a student of Rahul College. I am level 4 student of Part 2 Success International Master. I am going to present history of dinosaurs. This is the content of my presentation. First, I am going to do introduction. Next, eras they lived. Then, their appearance. Next, dinosaurs' habitats. Then, their feeding styles. Extinction of dinosaurs. Finally, where do they live nowadays? Introduction. Eras they lived. Introduction. Dinosaurs lived on the earth 160 million years ago. They died out long before people came along. They were lived in Mesozoic era, a very long span of time in the earth's history. Talk about eras they lived. There are three eras dinosaurs lived on the earth: Jurassic era, Jurassic era, and Cretaceous era. First, dinosaurs lived in Jurassic era. Then, dinosaurs lived in Jurassic era. Finally, dinosaurs extinct Cretaceous era. Let's we talk about appearance. Scientists believe that archosaurs were the Scientists believe that archosaurs were the ancestor of dinosaurs. They had long and strong hind legs. They had short forelegs and they had long tail to keep it balanced. They were 45 meters long and they had good eyesight. They were vertebrate animals too. Next, we talk about dinosaurs' habitats. Dinosaurs lived only on land, on grassland or forest. Dinosaurs can't swim or fly. Type of dinosaur. Stegosaurus. Stegosaurus name means roof lizard. Oviraptor. Oviraptor name is Ectyp. Scientists believe that this dinosaur steal another dinosaur's eggs. Brachiosaurus. Brachiosaurus is the large dinosaur in the world. Rhinoceros. Rhinoceros is a carnivorous dinosaur and the very hunted the another dinosaurs. Triceratops. They had three horns on their face. Feeding style of dinosaurs. There are three feeding styles of dinosaurs. Carnivores. Dinosaurs are meat eaters. They have saw-like teeth designed to tear food. This is the first picture. You can see a T-Rex hunted by the dinosaur. Herbivorous dinosaurs are plant eaters. They had flat cheek teeth designed for plucking and grinding plants. There is a second picture. You can see herbivorous animals. Omnivorous dinosaurs that ate both plant and root plant and animal. Why did dinosaurs become extinct? The dinosaurs extinct. They suddenly died at volcanic eruption. It might have generated enormous amounts of carbon dioxide and clouded the sky with volcanic ash. Due to the destroy of ozone layer, harmful radiations might come to the earth. At the time that dinosaurs died out, the earth's climate changed drastically. Perhaps the dinosaurs may have died due to the cold weather. The Earth was struck by big meteor shower. It caused to extinct dinosaurs too. Can we see them now? Of course not. They were extinct animals. We can't see their fossil and skeleton of only. Scientists brought the dinosaurs back into the world. Now they live in the museum. Now it is our responsibility to protect them. Thank you for my presentation.
Right, Dinucha, well done. Though you are a newcomer to the class, now this is your second day. I really appreciate the effort that you had taken to take part in the contest, though this is your second day. Right, well done, Dinucha. Timer, can you please report his time?
Contestant number 7, Dinuja Ranasimha. His time was 5 minutes and 33 seconds.
All right. Then let's move to contestant number 8, Senuja Dinhas. Senuja, can you please turn on the camera? Right. Great. Okay. Senuja, you can share the screen and start to present.
Respected judge, teacher, and all my friends. Today, I'm going to present about the history of mobile phones. I am a student of Mohanlal National College. I'm in grade 8. My name is Sarodhi Nas. The mobile phone or smartphone we use now are not made all at once and gradually become what it is today. Many people think that the various mobile phones of today are the big hall phone that we usually refer to as the first generation large phones. But these big hall phones are only one step in the history of mobile phones. The history of mobile phone goes back to 1800. In 1876, Alexander Graham Bell discovered that sound traveled through the water and air as a stream of electrons and based it on a machine that transmits the human voice into a stream of electrons and transfer it through a copper wire to the telephone. Alexander Graham Bell was born on March 13, 1847 in a Scotland city called Chicago. Do you know the first word spoken after making this telephone? Mr. Watson, come here. I want to see you. That word was first spoken on the telephone. The telephone was invented by Alexander Graham Bell and was improved by Martin Cooper in 1973 to the mobile phone. Martin Cooper was born on December 26, 1928 in United States city called Chicago. He earned his master's degree from IIT in electrical engineering and 2004 received an honorary doctorate degree from IIT. The famous Motorola company introduced this mobile phone to the world in 1980 as a new product. When we talk about mobile phone, we should also talk about our country. As the first country in South Asia to successfully launch a mobile phone network 33 years ago. The tech company called IBM is widely credited with developing the world's first smartphone, the bulky but rather cutely named Simon. It went on sale in 1994 and featured a touchscreen, email capability, and a handful of built-in apps, including a calculator and a sketchpad. That is how a smartphone came to be. In the year 2000, the smartphone was connected to an actual 3D network. In other words, a mobile communication standard was built to allow portable electronic devices access to the internet wirelessly. On January 9, 2007, Apple Inc. CEO Steve Jobs unveiled the iPhone, a touchscreen mobile phone with an iPod, camera, and web browsing capabilities among their features at the Macworld convention in San Francisco. Let's watch this short video.
Well, today we're introducing three revolutionary products of this class. The first one is a widescreen iPod with touch controls. The second is a revolutionary mobile phone. And the third is a breakthrough internet communications device. So, three things. A widescreen iPod with touch controls, a revolutionary mobile phone, and a breakthrough internet communications device. An iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod, a phone. Are you getting it? These are not three separate devices. This is one device. And we are calling it iPhone.
That's how the big phone that they are in the beginning evolved into the smartphone we use now today. Thank you for being with me. Over to you, teacher.
Thank you, Sehas, for sharing your knowledge about the history of mobile phones. Timer, can you please report his time?
Contestant number 8, Senuja Dinhas. His time was 6 minutes and 20 seconds.
Right. With that presentation, this presentation contest came to an end. This indeed was a wonderful exhibition of talents of the senior students of Path to Success International Mathura. I feel so blessed and I'm pleased to see the talents of my students being in the audience today. So let's take some time and let's listen to a beautiful song till our Madam Judge Kanchana Kristambu finalizes the results. Right. Now I invite our Madam Judge, Ms. Kanchana Kristambu, to announce the results. And also we appreciate if you can give constructive comments for the development for our students. I welcome Ms. Kanchana Kristambu on screen.
Thank you, teacher. So I have to say, it was very hard for me to choose winners because everyone is in here is very talented and they have worked so hard to make these presentations. They were very informative and I learned so much things about history on under different topics. So actually I never expected this much of a talent from students of your age. So keep this up, guys. You have gotten a great exposure through Miss Priyanti. So don't stop learning English. Always continue learning English because the language evolves every day. So it is important to learn English every day. So never stop learning English. And also about the presentations, you guys are very talented. The presentations were very creative and very informative. I have no words to describe. I'm so happy. And thank you, teacher, for inviting me for this event to be a judge. Actually, I am very, I don't have in words to describe how talented they are. So I have selected. Even this is very difficult for me, I have selected some winners, but don't get discouraged. You all are very talented. It was very hard for me to select winners. Ma'am, shall I announce the winners?
Yes, Ms. Kanchana, you may, please.
Okay. It was very hard. So everyone in here is a winner, okay? So I have selected three third places. First third place goes to Senuja and Netuli and Sehas. Those are the students who have received the third place, and I have selected two second places. First one is Harita, second one is Chama. And the first place goes to Ramiro. Congratulations, you all. And I have two merit awards. The first merit award goes to Dinuja. As teacher mentioned, this is your second day, right? So you have done a great job. Keep it up. So the second merit award goes to Umed. Congratulations, you guys.
Ms. Kanchana, can you please repeat the second merit award, the name of the second merit award winner?
Yeah, Umeda.
Umeda, thank you so much, Ms. Kanchana. Then let's welcome the winners on screen. Yes. We have three third place winners. Senucha, can you please turn on the camera, Senucha? And Netuli. Netuli, please turn on the camera. Okay. And Sehas, please turn on the camera, Sehas. Sehas is not to be seen. Right now, these are our third place winners. Let us all give them a big clap and appreciate their effort today. And the second place winners, Harita, can you please turn on the camera, Harita? Right, okay. Harita and Chama. Chama, can you please turn on the camera? Yes. Chama, and our champion of today's contest, Ramiru. Ramiru, can you please turn on the camera? Yes. Let us all give them a big round of applause. Well done. And congratulations, all the winners. And let us also welcome the Merit Award winners. Now, today we have two Merit Award winners. Wait a bit. Right, we have Dinucha. Dinucha, can you please turn on the camera? Yes, Dinucha. And Umeda. Umeda. Yes, Umeda. Right now, these are our Merit Award winners of today's contest. Congratulations, and let us all give them also a big round of applause. Right. Thank you, Ms. Kanchana. We value your constructive comments given for the development of our students. Once again, we extend our gratitude for accepting our invitation and present here as the judge amidst a very busy schedule of work. And we wish you all the very best for your future endeavors in life. And we wish to have your presence in our future contest too as the judge. Thank you so much, Ms. Kanchana.
Thank you, Tisha, for inviting me for this. This is actually, I'm so happy that I said yes to this. I'm always ready to come back as a judge.
We are glad to hear it, Kanchana. Right, then all the students, can you please turn on your cameras and say thank you, madam? Say thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam. All right. Okay. Time has come to draw the curtain for this wonderful event. I hope all our guests are enlightened with new knowledge. I express my sincere thanks for all the students who worked hard in making presentations and their parents who guided and facilitated them. Without your contribution, this event would never be a success. I hope to see you again soon. Till then, goodbye and good night. Good night to you all.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, teacher.
Good night, teacher.
Good night, teacher.
Bye.
Good night, teacher. Our friend Sehas has logged in now. He didn't know that he was a winner. Right. Okay, Sehas. Sehas, hello? Sehas? Hello, Sehas, I hope that you can hear me.
Yes, teacher.
You got the third place, Sehas. Can you please turn on the camera? Yes, Yes, congratulations, right? You got the third place. You were not there when we announced the results, right? Okay. Then we have come to the end of today's contest, everybody. Right, then we'll meet again soon. Till then, goodbye and good night.